help with that rummage sale. A lot of people to set up, to clean up, a lot of people to donate, and a lot of people came and bought. As of now, we have we raised over $3,000 yesterday, and that is great. We have a few pending items on Craigslist, and if they come through, we're going to be dancing. So you can pray for that. You put in your bulletin a Holy Week schedule, because we want you to be sure and circle the dates from Palm Sunday to Maundy Thursday to Easter Sunday, and plan to be with us as we worship together as friends and members. Two big women events on Mondays. One is March 14th at 11:30 at Key Holiday Inn. You see Rose Way or Susan Olson if you have not yet signed up. Then the PWA Fish Card Party at the Kirk. And details are in your bulletin. We have a strained group that plays in the other service. It is Jim and Shauna Gaskell. And the Kirk is going to feature them at a concert on Monday, April the 3rd. Details are in here. We would love for you to support them. There are flyers in the back if you have a place that you could put out. We're just so pleased that the Gaskells are with us here at the Kirk. If you're visiting with us, you will find out in a minute that we don't take up an offering. But if you want to help us with the ministry of the church, there is a cross church in the back as you leave, and you can help us in our ministry here. Every Sunday, I invite those of you that have been visiting with our church to consider joining our church, and so I want to do that today. If you are looking for a church home, we would love to have you a part of the Kirk. You can join our church by profession of your faith in Jesus Christ, by reaffirmation of your faith, by transferring your membership from another church, or you can keep your membership in your home church, and you can become an affiliate or an associate member here. If you would like to do that, you can speak to me today as you leave, and we will get a couple elders together, and would love to have you as our newest member. I'd like to invite Tricia Farthing and Linda Escobar, if she's here. Come on up and stand by me, girls. Last week, Tricia joined our church by transfer of her membership, and Linda chose to be an associate member, keeping her membership in her home church. I'd like to ask you all a faith question. Do you believe in God, that Jesus is the Son of God and the Savior of your sin? And do you trust in Him alone for salvation as He has offered to you in the gospel? And do you promise to support our church and our worship and work? Do you? I want you to join me in welcoming our very newest member.
Thank you.
you in my bag today. So on the count of three, I want you to ask me what's in the bag. One, two, three.
What's in the bag?
That's it.
What is this?
Sorry.
When you're driving a car and you see this, what are you supposed to do? Do you know some people think it stands for slow tires on pavement? But it means stop. It means come to a complete stop and then move forward. You know, one thing I've noticed about you, the children, you have a hard time stopping. You've got a motor that's going. And that's what we love about children at this church. Will you bring some energy and some life and some love that no doesn't come to us any other way? And we thank you so much. We thank you for stopping on Sunday here at the Kirk. We thank you for coming inside and being a part of our family. So, I want you to know that your church, we really love you, and we are glad you have stopped in today. I'm going to ask you to pray with Pastor Jim. You know how we do it. We fold our hands, we place them under our chin like Pastor Jim. We close our eyes and pray in our outside voice. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For speaking.
For speaking.
To us.
To us.
When we stop.
When we stop.
Help us.
Help us.
To stop.
To stop.
And hear your voice.
And hear your voice.
We ask this prayer.
We ask this prayer.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Bye-bye. Thank you.
song, it's called Waiting Here for You.
Sing us one of the songs of Zion. How could we sing the Lord's song, how foreign land. If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand wither. Let my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth. If I do not remember you, if I do not set Jerusalem above my highest joy. And then turning over and reading the words from the prophet Isaiah. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. Those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of the Lord. Would you bow your heads and pray with me? Now I pray, O Lord, that as we gather together as your people, help us to focus the ears of our heart as you speak to us of important things that you would want us to focus on as we seek to be godly men, women, boys, and girls. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Waiting times of life are stagnant. It's not a lot of movement. We spend waiting times exhausted. There's something inside of us that is pushing us to move forward. We don't know where to go. Waiting times are, we know what has happened in the past, and we know what's going on now. We don't know what's ahead. Waiting times are difficult. They're different. The in-between times are different for everyone. Take Johnny, a teenage boy. All of his friends know exactly what they want to do with their life. They know what they want to do for a vocation. They know where they want to go to school. They know what they want to study, but Johnny doesn't have a clue. Johnny is like a lot of us. He just hasn't been motivated enough. He doesn't have a clear movement as to what to do. Mary is the only one of her friends who's not married. She wants to be married. She wants to have a husband. And she's waiting. She's waiting. It doesn't seem like it's ever going to happen. Roger and Martha want to have a child. They've been trying. Been to every fertility clinic they could afford. And they want to have a baby. But it's not happening. Those times were oh so painful. A couple planned their whole life to retire and to spend part of their time up north, or other part of their time in paradise. In Maranatha. But things didn't work out. Daddy and Mama still working. And setbacks. Their dreams still there. The waiting times are difficult. I don't know about you, but I'm tempted to skid tires on pavements. What I see a stop sign. What I try to do is picture where that policeman is parked. It's difficult to wait for somebody to come home. It's been gone a long time. It's difficult to wait for the phone call when the person said, I'll get right back to you. And it's been over 24 hours. It's difficult to wait for the phone to ring with the doctor on the other end to tell you what those test results are. Waiting times are extremely difficult, but you need to hear this. God allows us to have those times. He wants to come into our waiting times and give us guidance and give us direction. The Bible says
in Isaiah 40:31, but they who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength, and they shall mount up with wings as eagles, and they shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. In Psalms 40:1, I wait patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. And then in Jeremiah 29:11-14, it says, I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for calamity, to give you a future and a hope. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me, and when I search for me, when you search for me with all your heart, and I will be found by you, declares the Lord, and I will restore your fortunes and will gather you from all the nations and from all the places where I have driven you, declares the Lord. Praise God. I have a little testimony waiting on the Lord. That's real quick. 4 years ago this March, I was privileged to have a complete stroke on the left side. I couldn't move my legs, couldn't move my arms, and it was quite different than what I've been used to all my life. And as the pastor talked about waiting patiently, I waited patiently at Fisherman's Hospital to be able to get a ride up to Baptist Hospital. And finally they came and they picked me up and took me up there. And as I was riding that hour, I waited patiently on the Lord. And I said, Lord, use me where you can. And at this time, I was completely paralyzed. It was just like limp. And the Lord said to me, just like I'm talking to you right now, be patient with me, and I will raise you up the third day. So I went into the hospital telling the people, I'll be all right in 3 days. And they said, it's no way. And I said, let me tell you something. My Lord spoke to me and told me I'll be out of here in 3 days. And in that third day, I was out. Thank you. Praise the Lord.
The Bible also tells us that Moses spent one-third of his life waiting. Waiting for he didn't know what. He had killed an Egyptian. And he had run for his life, and he was caught out in the wilderness where he became a shepherd. And the area that he tended the sheep was extended when he became God's leader to take God's people out of bondage in Egypt to the promised land, right over the area where God had him waiting as a shepherd. You see, instead of fighting the waiting times of life, you and I need to learn to wait patiently. Jesus' earthly ministry was 3 years. So what did he do in the first 30? He waited. He learned. As a child, he spent time in the temple. He learned from his parents. He became a carpenter. He learned what life was about. He had brothers and sisters that he had to get along with. And in those waiting times, God prepared him for 3 years to save the world. What about if Jesus and Moses had spent their waiting time griping, complaining, sinning, taking the matters of their life into their own hands, and not waiting on God? But they didn't. They allowed God to speak to them in the waiting times of life. Oftentimes, you and I need to take a check. How are we doing in the waiting times? pictures the people of Israel in captivity in Babylon. It says in our passage that when they got there, they sat down by the waters of Babylon, signifying that they couldn't be in Israel, they couldn't live in Jerusalem and worship at the temple, they quit. And so they sat down and did nothing. It also said they wept. You and I know there's nothing wrong in weeping. I believe that men need to cry more. It's just hard for some men to cry. There are times when I want to cry. I just can't keep it up. And so what I want you to hear is that that's all they did was cry. And we know people that life is so sad, that's all they do. They can't find joy anywhere, and they just cry. It also says they hung up their hearts on the willow trees, and their captors wanted them to sing songs. The people of Israel were known for singing praises to their God, but they refused. They said, how do you expect us to worship God in a foreign land? So they quit. They didn't say. World War II, Adolf Hitler's German Air Force were raiding London, England almost every night and bombing and causing destruction. The people of London wanted King George and his family to go to Canada until the war was over. But he refused, and he stayed. One morning after a night of bombing, King George was walking out among the ruins and saw one of the citizens, and the citizen hollered and said, King George, you are a great man. King George hollered back to him, you are a good people. Together we're going to make it. It inspired a songwriter to write these words. There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see. There'll be tears, but there'll be laughter. And there'll be joy ever after tomorrow. Just you wait and see. In my life, I believe that the sun will come out tomorrow. But I don't believe the sun that I'm referring to is exclusive to the beautiful sunrises over the Gulf where I live. I believe Jesus will be there tomorrow. So let me ask you this. Do you make the most of your waiting times? When you are caught between treatments of a disease, when you're caught in a chapter of your life that is not pleasant and you aren't happy, what do you do with the waiting times of life when relationships in your family are not going well? What do you do with the waiting times when you're needing more financial means in order to get ahead? Do you believe that there'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover? Do you believe that God will come smiling into your life with joy in the midst of the wait? Here at the Kirk, friends and members, we are in a waiting time. We're in between permanent pastors. We call it transition. In that transition time, you have a transitional pastor. Mwah. And in those waiting times, we can choose to quit. And some of us have quit. And they're gone. Some will be back, some won't. You chose not to quit. You chose to stick in there. As your transitional pastor, I want to tell you, let's make the most out of this time. Let's be the church. Let's worship together. Let's pray together. Let's hear the word of God, and let's strengthen each other. Let's let our faith grow. Let's come to the Kirk expecting that God can do far more than you and I can ask or think. God will strengthen us. Will you let Him? You know something? The book of the past is closed. The present is open. And we haven't yet turned the page to see what's ahead. And the joy of the Lord can be our strength. Would you pray with me? Lord, we confess to you it's not easy to wait. We are so used to making decisions that we just plow ahead and fail miserably. Lord, we need to learn to wait on you, to strengthen us, to hold us, to be close to us. Lord, in this quiet time, let us focus on you. A God who has given us Jesus to come to us in our quiet moments and minister to our hearts, to encourage our spirit. Lord, we can't imagine anything better than Jesus. And so as we wait, strengthen us. As we wait, give us a hope in you, that you love us and the Kirk, and you have a plan that includes the transitional time. Lord, guide us. Guide us in our quest to be godly men, women, boys, and girls, and to be the church that you want us to be, and to love each other and forgive each other and strengthen each other as we move forward in our faith. We dedicate our lives to you during the transition. As we wait for the next permanent pastor, Lord, we pray that you would be holding us ever close to you. We lift up to you those that are heavy on our hearts, those who are sick, who are lonely, who are in prison, who are having tough times at work. We lift up to you the men and women of our military who serve this country and oftentimes put their lives in harm's way so that we can be free. We lift up to you the leaders of our world, our country, our state, and the keys. Lord, we lift up to you those that are making decisions that you would give them clear direction. Lord, as we lift all these to you, we know that you can minister and you can move in supernatural ways into their calamities. We pray, Lord, that you would heal, that you would give guidance, you would be compassionate and kind and loving. We ask you, Lord, as we lift up those, we pray, Lord, that you would minister to their every need. Lord, as we wait, teach us to pray as Jesus taught his to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
This next song is called In Christ Alone. Would you please stand?
Now you got to move back.